This system that I have actually done with the Atmega chip is usually called as the dawn to dusk system. So if you're going to Amazon.in or searching in eBay and you find a system which lights up the street lights or the garden lights when the sun goes down, this is almost the same setup that you will find if you break it up. This is a pack of cool white LED strips. It's a 50-50 LED, meaning that each LED is a 50mm square. These LEDs are huge and can give a good amount of light. As most LED strips, this one too has a cutting mark after every 3 LEDs. So I measure, mark and stick them to the sheet. I have to make parallel connections. So I'm just connecting all the positives here. I love soldering, and when it is pre-trimmed, then it's the most satisfying. It is not necessary that we have to clog by connecting wires very near, so I chose different rails for positive and negative wires. After this, I will explain the circuit. Here's the solar panel, and this DC jack is the output of it. Now, I connected to a step-up boost converter. Because of the daylight, as it reduces or increases, the voltage from the solar panel might decrease. So this one will keep it at a constant 12 to 13 volts. And now that I will connect it to the solar panel. But before you connect the solar panel power terminals over here, the manual says that I have to connect the battery first. So that's what I'm gonna do. It immediately starts lighting up, showing that the battery is charged almost 75%, which is good. Then I can go ahead and connect the solar panel. Okay, that's done. Right now, the charge LED is lighting up very dim. That's because we are indoors, but still it's lighting up, which means that there is a voltage. Actually, I measured the voltage. It's around 4 volts that is coming right now. Now, according to the manual, the final system that I have to connect is the load. And for the load, I've used a custom board that I made. But before that, I want to explain you what is a solar charge controller. You cannot connect the solar panel directly to the battery because sometime during the peak hours when the sun is directly on top of the solar panel, it will generate a really large amount of voltage and which will heat up the battery and eventually swell and burst. And the charge controller protects from doing that. It gives a constant charging voltage to it. This is a PWM charge controller. There is MPPT charge control also, which is an efficient way, but that's for higher wattage of batteries. This is a small project, so this one, a PWM solar charger, is much more enough. So what this does is it gives us constant charging voltage to this, and the charge controller's job is to protect it from over discharging also. This charge controller also has a short circuit protection. This is ideal for this project. And that's why I'm not going to connect these terminals directly to the battery terminals, but onto the load terminals. Here's the breadboard connection. The top rail is powered by the Arduino. It gives 5 volts here. There is also a separate connection, a 12 volt connection given at the bottom rail. The photoresistor is connected to the plus rail on one lead, and the other lead is connected to a 10k ohm resistor. The same lead is also connected to the analog input of the Arduino, to the pin number A0. The MOSFET here I've used is a n-channel MOSFET, and it's IRFZ44N. The source pin is connected directly to the negative rail. The drain pin is connected to the LED roll, and the gate pin is connected to digital pin 4. The code that I've written is, whenever the input value from the resistor goes below 100, then it lights up the roll. You can find the schematics of the circuit diagram in the description. Now that we see the breadboard connection, let me explain you what happens here. This is the 12 volt input that comes from the load terminal of the solar charge controller. That is going to a LM7805 voltage regulator, which pumps out constant 5 volts. And the reason that does is the Atmega chip runs only at 5 volts, so we need that. And these are the crystals and disc capacitors for the Atmega chip. These two are the smoothing capacitors which smoothen the input and the output voltage. And the small resistor and the LED is to indicate if the board is on or off. And to switch on and switch off the LED panel, we use a IRFZ44N MOSFET over here. Switch on the circuit and you can see the red LED glowing up, which means that the circuit is on. So if I'm going to go ahead and block the photoresistor, the LEDs will switch on immediately. Also, I forgot to mention you that the battery that I use is a 12 volt 1.7 amperes. I assembled all these electronics here just to explain it to you. Now I'm going to disassemble it and then put it inside the backlit board so that I can mount it outside my shop. The solar panel will be obviously far away from the backlit board, so I need to mount this DC jack where it is visible outside. It's all assembled now and it's the moment of truth. I'm very excited. There you go. I'm just trying to block the photoresistor and I couldn't be happier. I'm going to hide it temporarily, like somewhere like this, so that I can come in the front and see for myself. Oh, here the charge controller is actually being seen. That's one minus point. I can't keep the charge controller outside because when it rains, obviously it's gonna get wet and that can't happen. So I have to keep it inside. Now that it is done, I'm getting a lot of new ideas which I can do with the dawn to dusk concept. Let me know in the comments if you wanna see more such videos about that. There are some improvements that I wanna do to this project. First, instead of using a voltage regulator, I want to use a buck converter. Voltage regulators are very inefficient and do not want to use it when you're working with a battery. The second is to add a switch which cuts off the load from the charge controller, just as a safety measure. One important point to note is that the wire from the battery should always be shorter. Because it's a DC voltage, longer wires are super inefficient. I hope I have covered all the points, but if you feel I have missed some points, please ask me in the comments and I shall reply. If you enjoyed this video, please click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel. The more you share and subscribe, the more it helps me out. Also check out my Instagram page. I have uploaded a video summing up all these things in just under 30 seconds. Thank you for watching. Until next time, happy learning.